This is the flag of a revolution.
Yes.
It was not just a revolution about breaking away from the mother country. It was a revolution that people said, you can't take us for granted anymore. You can't take our lives and our money. You can't send us into your horrid wars, imperial wars. You can't take our wealth. You can't require us to work for your overlords. It was a real revolution. And that's, he said, and the revolutionary weapon we will use, because we don't have the guns that the British and their mercenaries had. We don't have the power, we don't have the money. But we're creating something brand new. We've got a vote. This revolutionary new weapon that could not be stopped. This 4th of July, you're going to tell them you're not taking it away. Donald Trump, one of the reasons he won, and I talked to, I can't say the name, one of the highest officials in Ohio, who said, my God, Hillary comes to Ohio and talks about the wonders of NAFTA and free trade. And Donald Trump stood in front of the gates of Delphi Automotive, the auto parts company. Every single job was lost. Every single UAW job was lost. The plant was shut down and moved lock, stock, and barrel to Monterrey, Mexico. Donald Trump stood in front of those closed plant gates and said, I will give you back your job. Day one, NAFTA, the worst deal ever, is toast. And you know what? Maybe some, you know what? People aren't racist to vote for their jobs, get their jobs back, even though they could smell the mendacity, the fakery. Was this true? Is it like going to a Trump casino that you're going to get rich, right? Here's a guy who made his money by getting working for people to hand over their paychecks and saying we had a wonderful time. He's doing it again. So now, he said, I will put an end to this. Day one. And by day, we're getting towards 200. And NAFTA has not been touched. He barely kissed it. Because to move that plant back from Monterey to Ohio, you would have to return some of the tariffs on auto parts. And the guy who would negotiate that, of course, is the Secretary of Commerce. And the Secretary of Commerce, his name is Wilbur Ross. And Wilbur Ross is the guy who owns the goddamn plant in Mexico. Wilbur ain't doing no job right in Mexico. He certainly ain't going to hit himself with tariffs. So what it is, when we're talking about vote theft, what we're really talking about is simply the mechanism of a billionaire's coup d'etat. And that's what's going on.
And this is Greg Palast reporting for JusticeNewsNetwork.com.